A very good evening to all of you. This is Shivam Shukla and here I am to draw a problem on projection of solids. It's a three-stage problem on cone. The question statement goes as, a right circular cone of base 60mm diameter and axis 75mm long is lying on VP on one of its end generator. This entire thing statement is stage number 2. I'll be telling you how it is. Draw projections of the cone when the front view of the axis inclined at 45 degrees with HP and base is nearer to the observer. This entire statement is stage 3. Friends, why it is stage number 2 directly? A cone will be lying on end generator on a particular plane only when in first stage it will be kept like this on the same plane. That is why, let me say, this is the vertical plane, this is the horizontal plane. Now this is the XY line, and over here for this particular problem we will be starting with the front view like this, we will be starting with the top view like this. So solution is stage 1, since we are starting with front view, we will be drawing the top view next. Second stage, we will be drawing the top view, redrawing the top view, then we will be making the front view. Third stage, we will be drawing the front view and then we will be drawing the top view. So it's a university problem, asked for 15 marks. Question number 2, December 2019 CGS question for 15 marks. So stage 1 is already drawn, let us proceed further for stage 2. It's lying on VP on one of its end generators. So now this 5O has to lie down completely on this XY line. So already what do I do? From here, the distance from 5 to O will be taken in compass. Once it is taken, I'll be putting it over here and cutting it. So I will be getting from here, this is O. So 5 to O distance is there and it is cut. Now, I will be taking the distance same from 1 to O, that is, or O to 1. I'll be cutting it over here. The same distance it will be going to be, my dear friends. And then 5 to 1, that is the base distance. That is the last distance, that is 5 to 1. Once I get this distance, then from 5, I'll be keeping it over here and I'll be cutting the arc at 1 over here. Once I get this point, I can name it as over here as 1. And then I can reconstruct this entire triangle. So this will be 5 to 1. It will be joined as dark line. That is the base. And O21 and O25, it will be dark. Again, as the end generators. This is it. Again, this is the other one. Once we are done with this, let me draw the inner generators one by one. So now, from 5 to 7,3, distance I'll be taking in compass. I have taken it. And I will be cutting the arc over here. So this I can mark it as, here itself 7,3, one more point it will be there as O1. Now for 8,2 and 6,4, it will be equidistant from the center. So like this I will be taking it, which is equidistant. On both the sides I can cut the arcs like this and like this. Okay, so for 7,3, this particular distance, if I take it, so this will be 8,2 over here and this will be 6,4. Okay, so once I am done, I will be simply joining the faint generators for the mid. This is 6,4 from here till here. It will be joined as a faint generator because these generators be seen as very faint, actually they won't be seen, and actually it's not required to be shown. So now only the axis line that you can see, the true length of the axis, so it will be marked like this. Okay, so I can just mark it over here. This is true length of axis, which is nothing but 75 mm. Now I'll be taking all the projections for the front view from the top view. One by one, perpendicular to the XY line, I'll be getting all the projections from here. Okay. So it will be like this. You can just see to it. one by one all the points being getting projected up. Once we have projected them, let us last but not the least project this point as O, which will be projected like this. Okay. Once we are done, let us project all the points from the front view, for the front view in stage 2. So I can write it over here. So I can take the projections individually one by one like this. So it's over here like this. These all projections will be parallel to the XY line. Okay. So it is like this and like this. The last one, that is the point number 7. As you all can see, all the points being projected. So one by one, let's name these points. Mention these points. So this is 5. So it will be 5 dash over here. This will be 1 dash over here. Okay. Now what about 6, 4? So here it is the point number 4 dash. And the same way, if I talk about 6, so point number 6 will be over here. So this is point number 6 dash. Now 7, 3. So this is 3 dash and this is 7 dash. Now 8, 2, it will be 2 dash over here and it will be 8 dash over here. Last but not the least one, it is already being projected and this is nothing but O dash. And the point O1 was, which was over here for the front view, the point O1 dash will be over here. That will be giving us the O1 dash will be giving us the front view length of the axis. Now what do I do? One by one, I can just draw the ellipse since we are not having the French curve. So simply we'll be drawing it directly one by one. As you are seeing from here, my dear friends, let me make it very clear to everyone. For the front view, you will be looking from here. So entire bottom base is visible to us. From here you will be looking and this is the one. That is O21 edge, as well as that is end generator, and this O25 particular surface entirely will be seen to us. So that is why the entire base is going to be dark. So let me make it as dark. So let us join it with the help of this curve. So I'll be joining it like this. Okay. Even for these points, can join it like this, can join it like this and like this. Okay. Since you can see it's a sharp curve, so that's why from this O dash directly we can join this point 7 dash, which will be coming to it as a tangent. Even from O dash to 3 dash, it will be seen as a tangent. Now what happens for rest of the lines? If I see for rest of the lines, points, it will be joined as a faint lines, or what is specific or required for us is nothing but the front view length of the axis. That is nothing but O1 dash to O dash. So from here till here, I'll be joining it as the front view length to be marked as very specific. And it will be extended beyond. Okay. And now whatever the other points are there to be joined as very faint, as these are the mid generators which actually won't be seen, so we will be just joining them as very faint. Actually these are not required to be constructed, but still we can just show it for construction sake. Okay, so once we are done, I'll be writing it from O1 dash to O dash is nothing but front view length of axis or elevation length of axis. Okay, so now what it is given, mentioned in stage number 3, Draw projections of the cone when front view of the axis inclined at 45 degree with HP and base is nearer to the observer. Now, this particular cone is there. It can be tilted either like this or the other way. So we will be tilting it the other way because while we will be looking for the finishing stage, finishing view, that is the top view, at that time the base will be nearer to the observer. That is why it will be tilted like this. So I will be proceeding further now. So now what do I do? So from here, I will be simply taking and drawing the construction as over here. I will be just leaving a distance of, let me mark as 30 mm. Okay, so once I'm done, and the angle to be taken as 45 degrees from O1 dash. Okay, I can take a bit of more distance from here. I can start it from this. Okay. Now, what do we do? From O1 dash, I will be requiring a line at an angle of 45 degrees. So what do I do? Directly, I can get this O dash over here, and O1 dash, I can plot it later on. So what do we do? Directly, we need the angle of 45 degrees. So whatever is this distance from here, I can start it from the extreme end like this, and then what do I do? Directly, I can mark an angle of 45 degrees over here. Since it is given, front view of axis is inclined at an angle of 45 degrees with the XY line. Directly, I can take this particular distance in compass, point in compass. I'll be marking an angle of 45 degrees. Okay. So once I'm done with this, so what do I do? Randomly, let me mark this line first of all, which will be an axis line. And on that line, at a distance, let me say from here, at a distance of 10 mm, I'll be marking a point which I will be saying it as O dash over here. So once I'm done with O dash, let me proceed for the further diagram. So accordingly, now I can take in compass the point O1 dash. Okay. So from O dash to O1 dash in compass I have taken. I will be keeping it over here and I do cut the arc like this. So it's over here. Let me just make that as a complete line. Okay. So this is nothing but O1 dash. Okay. Even now from O1 dash, one by one I can plot all these points. Like this is 5 dash, and the same other will be the 1 dash. This is 5 dash over here. This is 1 dash over here. So then and there, once I make the cut the arcs, it's better to plot the points always. So 5 dash here, it will be 1 dash. What about these points 4 dash, 6 dash, and 8 dash to 2 dash? So for this, I'll be taking these particular distances in compass. From here, I'll cut the arc, and even on the other side, I'll cut the arc like this. So once I have cut the arcs, I'll just simply mark the points. Through all these points, I will be making the perpendicular lines. So it will be easier for me to go for the construction. So now, as you all can see, I'll be starting the lines from this particular point. So this is the first line. This is the second line. So this is the line that we require actually. This is the second line for one. This is the third line. Okay. So once we are done, let us just cut the arcs one by one. Okay, so now as you all can see, let's go for these points first. 6, 6, 4, 2 and 8. So it's over here. I can just take a particular distance of 6. So once I have taken this distance, I'll keeping the arc over here. This is 6, this will be 4, this will be 2, and the other one will be 8. On the other side it is 8. So now then and there I can just mark the points. So it was 6 dash, it was 4 dash, it was 2 dash, and this one was 8 dash. Once we are done with all these points, so last but not the least, the things those are left out for us are nothing but 3 dash and 7 dash. So now you can see it over here. This will be for 3 dash and the same one will be for 7 dash. This is over here for 3 dash and the same distance will be over here for 7 dash. Okay, so this is over here like this for 3 dash. This is over here for 7 dash. Now once we are done, let's construct again the similar kind of ellipse that we have drawn it over there. So it will be a smooth curve again, completed like this, since we have redrawn it. Okay, last but not the least, and this is the one. Okay, so once we are done, for this sake we can simply join it like this again, since we have redrawn it simply. So I can join the end generators from here, and again from point number 7 to the point O dash I can join it like this. Okay, this is O1 dash. I can mention this as front view of axis, which angle is given to us directly as the alpha. Alpha is equal to 45 degrees front view. Okay, so since the points were given to us, now let us take the projections and go for the top view one by one. We want, you can simply just show these lines, smaller lines. From here it is, and from point number 8 dash. So this is the way how it is completed. Okay, so once we are done, last but not the least, let us go take all the projections of the front view or the top view. It will be definitely perpendicular to the XY line, and let's start projecting them. This is the one, second, third, number fourth, one dash point, one dash, point number 6 dash, point number 8 dash, point number 7 dash, and point number O dash. Once these all points are projected down, let us take the projections of these for the top view, finishing top view. So now as you all can see, these projections how they are taken. Okay, and this is the one how it will be projected. Okay, so once we are done, let us project these points one by one. So as you all can see it over here, this is the point O dash was over here, so this is O. Now let me mark one by one all the points from left to right, or left to right. So this is 3 over here, so point number 3 is going to be over here. Now next will be 4, so 4 will be lying over here. As you all can see this particular projection, so this is 4, point number 2, so this is over here 2. point number 5. So this will be over here 5. Sorry, this was 2 and this is over here 5. So I can mark it over here 5. Point number 01 dash, so this I can mark it over here 01. So point number 1, so this will be over here, that is number 1. Point number 6, so this will be over here, this will be point number 6. Point number 8, which you can see like this, this is the projection smaller one, so this is the point number 8 over here. Point number 7, which will be lying over here like this. Last but not the least, this is point number O, which has come down over here. Now as you all can see, the main thing that we can show is base is nearer to the observer. So I can show it over here, I can show it over here and write it down very specifically, that is base nearer to the observer. Since the base is nearer to the observer, entire base will be seen as a visible to the observer. So let us draw that base first and then we'll be drawing the point tangents and then we'll complete the circle. Okay, so let me just complete it one by one. So from here I'll be starting it like this, like this. Okay, so definitely it has to be drawn with the help of the curve, that is French curve. Okay. Okay. This is the way how it will be getting completed. And last but not the least, my dear friends, it will be coming as a tangent, and as you can see it is coming very specifically with point number 8. So as you can see, I will be joining it over here and here it will be coming as a tangent to this particular point number 5. So it will be completed like this. Okay, so once we are done, we can show it like this. The same way the axis can be shown it over here like this. So this is done. Now let us see, go for the marks distribution one by one, how the marks are going to get distributed. Before that, simply let me join the points which will be shown as the generators one by one. 0 to 6, 0 to 4, 0 to 3, 0 to 2. And 0 to 1, because 0 to 8 is already a tangent point, tangent line like this. This is the way how the entire question gets completed. You all can see to it. Now let's see the marks distribution, how it is going to be. I can write it over here. First of all, stage 1 was already drawn. Stage 2 will be lying on VP on one of its end generator. Lying on VP on one of its end generator as well as front view of axis inclined at 45 degree with HP. Stage 3, I will be mentioning it over here. It is not required to be written in the paper, just for our knowledge sake we are writing it. Front view of axis inclined at 45 degrees to HP. As we are done, now let us finally go for the marks distribution. Stage 1, it will be 1 mark for the front view, 1 mark for the top view, 2 marks entirely. Stage 2, 2 marks for the top view, 2 marks for the front view. That is 6 marks total here. Last stage, finishing stage, 4.5 marks for the front view and 4.5 marks for the top view. This is how the 15 marks problem got covered. So total here it is 15 marks. So friends, this is how the problem gets completed. Please do like, subscribe and share this video. Thank you.